Hello and welcome to C++ Weekly. I'm your host, Jason Turner. I'm available for code reviews and on-site training. This is my fourth and currently my final planned episode on C++ homework. And this is probably the one that you least saw coming. So now just for a quick recap, I would like to point out that these episodes do not necessarily represent best practices. These are episodes designed to get you thinking about C++ and learning new things. Up to this point, we have had auto all of the things, const all of the things, and constexpr all of the things. Now, this episode title, as you have already seen, is Lambda, all of the things. Lambdas are interesting and different in C++ in that they are by default const. You must add a mutable keyword to a lambda if you want to mutate any of its captures. They are also, by default, implicitly constexpr enabled. So if you've been following along with some project, either the small pt example that I mentioned before, or one of your own projects, you are free to pick up where you last left off or to start from scratch and see how this changes things. So there's going to be several questions, like, does it make sense to make the operator plus a lambda? Probably not. And if you were to take this exercise to its extremes and make a static something like this, some sort of constexpr static lambda out there where you implement this plus operation, you can do that by all means, and you can see how it changes the code. Generally speaking, I think you're probably not going to want to make your member functions into lambdas, but it's certainly something to play with. Now, in the const all of the things episode, you probably used lambdas, at least in some cases, so that you could make values const. And this would be building on that. But you can play with this in a lot of different ways. You can make all of these global functions lambdas. You can split up lots of small portions of this code into lambdas. Or if you're using your own project, I'm guessing you have more free functions than we do here. But make your free functions lambdas and play with making your member functions lambdas and just kind of see what happens. What happens when you go too far with lambdas? Or is it possible for you to go too far? It is worth mentioning that I have suggested the small pt example for each of these exercises. And that is here. This is the small pt global illumination in 99 lines of C++. It generates a 3D scene with some spheres in it. You can execute it. It is a very small, self-contained example. It is now over 10 years old, so you know it's going to work, and you're going to have fun moving this thing to C++ 20. You can get the raw source code here, and if you do this, you can just easily copy and paste this into Compiler Explorer. Make sure you have C++ 20 turned on. Make sure you've got warnings enabled, because this is going to be a learning experience. You probably want to delete the pragma for OMP, and you probably want to format the document. And you know what? You probably want to add some parentheses in some places, because come on now. Like, does anyone actually write code like this? A for loop? There's no open brace here. Without this brace here, this entire for loop here is guarded, not guarded, but is part of this for loop. You know what? Yeah, You probably want to clean this code up if you start with this code, and if you start with your own version of it, you might be really happy with where you had already gotten. You might actually like the code that is consted and autoed and constexpr'd everywhere. And maybe you want to make a fork of that code or something to play with lambdas more and see what happens in your code. This is definitely a much more nebulous, less well-defined exercise compared to the previous three, but I still think that there's something enlightening here. Once you realize that you don't have to specify constexpr on a function, you don't necessarily have to specify const on a function, and it gets some of these defaults more right, and it does auto return type deduction for you by default, then you might actually prefer using lambdas in more places. I don't know. But again, I hope this one's fun for you, and I will have a place in the official C++ Weekly GitHub repository for you to post your examples for how your resulting code looked when you were done lambdaing all of the things. Thanks for watching this episode of C++ Weekly. I hope you liked it. I hope you are having fun with these homework assignments. Again, this is the last one that I have planned, but it's entirely possible more will pop up.